Southeast Radio's Business Matters with Karl Fitzpatrick. Southeast Radio.
While remote working is certainly an emerging trend which has captured the imaginations of employers and employees alike, and as a result, in recent years, we have witnessed the emergence of shared working hubs right across the country. The newest co-working facility, the new Work Junction, opened its doors in Clonard Village just 3 weeks ago, and the man behind this venture, Tom O'Neill, joins me now on the phone. Tom, start by providing us with an insight into the new Work Junction.
We're a small collection of co-working centres, which are shared working spaces. We're in Rathmines, Wexford, Carlow and Kilkenny. And it's a place where people who are remote working, freelancing, running startups or SMEs can get a flexible desk or office with no commitment to lease or anything of that sort, and get high-speed broadband and have co-workers, you know, in the social areas.
Now, this co-working space is an emerging trend in the Irish business community, but what's driving the demand for it?
Well, people's work lives are changing. People are demanding more flexibility from their employers, and they are making decisions, for example, to come and live in Wexford and work remotely, only occasionally commuting rather than commuting every day, obviously, to Dublin. So that's driving the remote working is where we're seeing the biggest uptick. And obviously there are startups as well, which can't sign up a lease for 5 years because they don't know what their business will be next month. And SMEs have a huge need as well. A sort of forgotten sector that keeps this economy going, really. So they'll often take an office, whereas your remote worker just needs 24/7 access, hot desk to come in and do their work and then go home and switch off from work, you know. So that's the growth.
And is the main opportunity in this market driven by the fact that we don't have high-speed broadband in rural areas across this country?
That's a big factor, Carl. You do need that reliable high-speed for conference calls, for working on video, for uploading stuff. You do need it. So that's a factor. And in fairness, towns like Wexford have got that now. And so it makes it. But it's also the social aspect. You know, coming into an adult workspace, getting the best of office life, leaving the office politics aside because you're working for different people, that's really good for people, you know. And once people move out of home into a co-working, they never go back.
And I suppose the reason I asked that question is because with the national broadband plan now being a reality, and it's certainly rolling out high-speed broadband across the country into rural areas over the next 5 to 10 years, how much of a threat do you see that to not just your own co-working space, but many of the others across the country?
I wouldn't see it at all for us, Carl, because we try and offer really good value so that it makes sense for people. Most people would prefer to be in a shared office space if they have the choice. So if you set the barriers right so they have, you know, respectful work environment and the price is right and so on, it's always better. There's a lot of other reasons for not working from home for most people. A lot of it is about, you know, work-life balance requiring work-life separation. It's really hard to wear two hats. And, you know, when the delivery man comes to the door, the dog is barking in the back of the conference call. It just doesn't work out for most people. But most importantly is being able to go back out home and switch off from work because you've done a day's work, rather than having this continuous flow of work into your entire evening, you know.
And how does the new Work Junction differentiate itself in the market?
Well, first of all, we're mostly focused on remote workers and freelancers, but also some startups. So for us, the collaboration and all that happens naturally. If people want to collaborate, there's a lot of common spaces. But otherwise, you get your head down and get to work in your hot desk. Other ones are much more focused on incubators for startups. We do some of that, but some of them are very collegial and very social all the time. And so for some people in more digital spaces or in architects, that they need to get their head down and they want to be in quiet space for quite a while as well, you know. So it's horses for courses, really, Carl, you know.
And many will say that the secret behind long-term success of any co-working space is the wraparound services that the facility can provide. What type of demand for those types of supports are coming from your own clients, let's say in Rathmines, Carlow or Kilkenny at the moment?
We provide the core, and then often, quite funny, if you leave people to it, they'll organise their own seminars. They bring in speakers. So, like, if you find there's a couple of people who are doing the same kind of design, UX design next to you, or an engineer who is interested, or an architect who wants some social media work done to them, people start collaborating, and then they will realize they need, you know, the support of a mentor or whatever to start a new group. And we can help with that because we have, like, you'll always have other people who are at a different stage of their startup and who know exactly how the ropes work, how to approach the local enterprise office, all of that. And all of those are hugely supportive as well. I must say, Wexford County Council has been enormously supportive with this. So their support is there for, you know, as much as you need.
Now, we've seen a huge number of co-working spaces appear over the last number of years, some of them in enterprise centres and lots of them standalone. Is there a fear or a concern here that maybe the market could be oversupplied at some stage?
I actually don't think so, Carl, because I think they're actually all quite different than each other and have different offerings for different people. We see it as sort of a collaborative thing, actually, with other co-working centres, try and get to know what other people's offers are and see if we can actually do communication with each other and collaboration with each other. We have a network, there's several hundred of them around the country now, and we communicate with each other on issues that affect all of us quite regularly, you know. And what my ideal would actually be was to get a kind of a common membership card, so that if you're down in Tralee for the weekend, you can actually pop into a sister co-working centre. There's no business connection, but we'll just decide, you know, so to give people even more flexibility when they're travelling and whatever else. I think that will happen too, you know.
That would be great, because I know that's certainly the model of Regis on a global basis.
Yeah, and Regis are in the space as well. They were serviced office before. They would probably be more competing with the likes of WeWork and various of the big ones. And mostly they're quite expensive, quite frankly, in my opinion. Okay, so that's so they suit corporates who are paying for overflow from their corporate offices in Dublin and so on. But they don't really affect us because they're not interested in the regional towns that much. Not so far anyway.
You've been open now 3 weeks in Clonard Village. What's the demand like so far, and who's it coming from?
It's picking up really well. It's quite encouraging. We have quite a diverse array of people in here already, like from writers through to engineers and textbook people, like remote workers and freelancers. The usual, the same mixes in Kilkenny actually is emerging here. And what's quite nice is it becomes self-sustaining after a while because people give work to each other and, you know, they sort of, when there's a freelance designer next door on the next desk to you, obviously that's the first person you're going to go to if you need your website updated and that kind of thing. So it's that, and it's SMEs. There's a few SMEs that moved in for the flexibility of office space and various projects. It's quite interesting. I think Wexford has a lot of folks working from home who are actually realising it's not ideal and looking for a space like this. So, as I say, similar town to in my overview, similar town to Kilkenny in the sense that quite a few people have made lifestyle choice decisions about living in, raising their family in Wexford, come what may, and they'll make their work suit their life.
Now, one of the key benefits of using a co-working hub such as the new Work Junction is the flexibility in relation to costs and, of course, having no requirement to enter into a lease. So how does the relationship work between the parties from a practical perspective?
It's a month-by-month basis, and you can scale up or scale down or opt out. Or like we have a few nomad workers as another variation of the thing. We have a few folks who work a few months with us, then a few months in Hanoi, a few months in the Philippines, a few months in Puerto Ventura, because their work allows them to do that. So they will just pay, you just pay a month in advance. We can even do shorter term than that if there's a need for it. And you have all the facilities while you're here. And then you just move on when it suits you, or upgrade or downgrade. And if a business thinks it needs an office and then finds the cash flow is not coming well, always pop down to a single desk or to even a casual desk. We have casual desks that are very cheap, or just an address, you know, for the time being if you're just going into hibernation, you know. So people do need that, you know. And the other thing is we're finding branches starting of European companies. In Kilkenny, we've had three companies already have started with one remote worker and suddenly a branch emerges around them. One of them ended up with like 15 staff in 12 months from one guy walking in. And the beauty of it is, because of the flexibility, as you mentioned, Carl, they can actually hit the ground running. They don't have to do a whole raft of paperwork before they can set up, try out a branch. They can dip the toe in the water, start a small team here. If it doesn't work out, they can move on with no hassle, you know.
Southeast Radio's Business Matters with Carl Fitzpatrick.